Hello everyone, welcome back to 2230. Today, we're delving deep into Singapore's latest government initiative aimed at supporting citizens facing involuntary unemployment. This groundbreaking scheme, unveiled by Manpower Minister Tan See Ling, comes as a beacon of hope for individuals navigating the tumultuous waters of unexpected job loss. At the heart of this initiative lies a comprehensive support system designed to cushion the impact of sudden unemployment while empowering individuals to chart a new course towards sustainable employment. Prime Minister Lee Hsien Loong first introduced this initiative during his National Day rally in 2023, emphasizing the government's unwavering commitment to aiding individuals in transition periods. PM Lee's vision for the initiative is clear: to establish a temporary safety net that not only addresses immediate financial needs but also fosters an environment conducive to upskilling and retraining. This forward-thinking approach underscores Singapore's dedication to nurturing a resilient workforce capable of thriving in the ever-evolving landscape of the global economy. Fast forward to Dr. Tan's address to Parliament on March 4, where he provided an update on the initiative's progress. He reassured the public that the government was nearing the finalization of scheme parameters, a testament to their commitment to swift and effective action. Moreover, Dr. Tan highlighted the extensive research undertaken, drawing insights from best practices around the world to inform the initiative's design. In his recent May Day message, Dr. Tan reiterated the Ministry of Manpower's dedication to adapting to economic shifts and disruptions. Recognizing the accelerating pace of change in the economy, he emphasized the need to bolster support for workers facing displacement through no fault of their own. This emphasis on agility and responsiveness underscores Singapore's proactive stance in navigating turbulent economic waters. The initiative forms part of a larger strategy aimed at fostering fair, progressive, and safe workplaces while equipping workers with the skills needed to thrive in future job markets. Enhancements to existing programs like Workforce Singapore's Career Conversion Program and the introduction of the Overseas Markets Immersion Program demonstrate Singapore's commitment to providing holistic support, including global market exposure and reskilling opportunities. Dr. Tan also underscored the government's ongoing efforts to ensure fairness and meritocracy in employment practices. Collaborating with tripartite partners, Singapore aims to shape workplace norms in alignment with forthcoming workplace fairness legislation, which will fortify protections against workplace discrimination, ensuring equal opportunities for all. In addition to supporting displaced workers, the government is focusing on empowering Singapore's growing older population. Dr. Tan outlined plans to progressively increase the retirement and re-employment ages to 65 and 70 by 2030, enabling senior workers to continue contributing to the workforce if they wish and are able to do so. To provide a comprehensive understanding, it's crucial to explore the historical context and previous policy debates surrounding unemployment support in Singapore. While the notion of implementing unemployment insurance has been discussed, the government has opted for a different approach, emphasizing retraining and upskilling initiatives like Adapt and Grow and Skills Future. Former Manpower Minister Josephine Teo highlighted the potential drawbacks of unemployment insurance, citing concerns about its impact on workers' motivation and employers' willingness to provide retrenchment benefits. In conclusion, Singapore's new initiative to support involuntarily unemployed citizens marks a significant milestone in the nation's ongoing efforts to build a resilient and adaptable workforce. With a focus on providing temporary financial assistance, upskilling opportunities, and safeguarding against discrimination, this initiative embodies Singapore's commitment to fostering inclusive growth and equitable opportunities for all. What are your thoughts on Singapore's approach to supporting unemployed citizens? Do you believe initiatives like these are effective in addressing the challenges of modern-day employment? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more insightful content from 2230.
大家好,欢迎回到2230. 今天我们将深入探讨新加坡政府最新的旨在支持面临非自愿失业的公民的举措。 这一开创性的计划由人力部长陈时隆介绍，对于在意料之外失去工作的人们来说，这是一道希望的光芒。这一举措的核心是一个全面的支持系统，旨在缓解突然失业带来的影响，同时赋予个人制定通往可持续就业的新路。李显龙总理在2023年的国庆献词中首次提出了这一倡议，强调了政府对帮助过渡期个体的坚定承诺。 李总理对这一举措的愿景是明确的，建立一个临时安全网，不仅解决了及时的财务需求，而且营造了一个有利于提升技能和再培训的环境。 这种前瞻性的思维方式凸显了新加坡致力于培养一个能够在全球经济不断变化的环境中蓬勃发展的韧性劳动力的决心。快进到3月4日陈时龙在国会上的讲话，他介绍了这一举措的进展情况。他向公众保证政府正接近最终确定方案的阶段，这证明了他们迅速而有效行动的承诺。此外，陈时龙强调了所进行的广泛研究，从世界各地的最佳实践中汲取了见解，以制定该计划的设计。在他最近的劳动节致辞中，陈时龙重申了人力部适应经济变化和干扰的承诺。他认识到经济变化的加速，强调了需要增加对因无过错而面临失业的工人的支持。这种对灵活性和应对能力的强调，凸显了新加坡在应对动荡的经济局势中的主动立场。该举措是旨在促进公平、进步和安全的工作场所的更大战略的一部分，同时赋予工人在未来就业市场上蓬勃发展所需的技能。对现有计划，如新加坡劳动力机构的职业转换计划的增强，以及海外市场融入计划的介绍，展示了新加坡提供全面支持的承诺，包括全球市场接触和在培训机会。陈时龙还强调了政府在就业实践中确保公平和公正的不懈努力。新加坡致力于与三方合作伙伴合作，塑造与即将出台的工作场所公平法规相一致的工作场所规范，这将加强对工作场所歧视的保护，确保所有人均享有平等的机会。除了支持失业工人外，政府还着眼于赋予新加坡不断增长的老年人口权利。陈时龙概述了逐步将退休和再就业年龄提高到2030年时的65岁和70岁的计划，使老年工人如果愿意并且能够继续为劳动力做出贡献。为了提供全面的理解，探讨新加坡失业支持的历史背景和以前的政策辩论是至关重要的。虽然曾讨论过实施失业保险的想法，但政府选择了不同的方法，强调了在培训和提升技能的倡议，如适应和成长以及未来技能。前人力部长张美容强调了失业保险的潜在缺点，提到了其对工人动力和雇主提供裁员福利的影响。总之，新加坡支持非自愿失业的公民的新举措，标志着国家不断努力建设一个有韧性和适应性的劳动力的重要里程碑。该举措着眼于提供临时财务援助、提升技能的机会以及防范歧视，体现了新加坡致力于促进包容性增长和为所有人提供公平机会的承诺。对于新加坡支持失业公民的方法，您有何看法？您认为这些举措是否有效解决了现代就业的挑战？请在下方评论区分享您的想法，别忘了点赞、分享和订阅，获取更多来自2230的见解性内容。